Ancient cathedrals and medieval castles throw their shadows on a stunning Italian landscape on the green shores of Garda Lake. This is a place of history and beauty. This is a place of steel and fire. This is the home of shotgun shooting. We are in Lonato, Italy, in the neighborhood of the city of Brescia, where most of the sport of shotgun came from. More than 500 athletes coming from 76 countries have come here from the 2nd of May through the 8th to compete in the five Olympic shotgun events of trap, double trap, and skeet shooting. Who's ready for the London Olympics? Who will storm Lonato's castle and secure the Italian gold? Since the Trap Conca Verde was built, there have been World Cups, World Championships, European Championships, and World Cup Finals organized here. The record of participants here was during the World Cup in 2010, with 79 countries and 600 shooters. And that record is still the world record for the most participants in a World Cup.
Ed è tuttora il record mondiale di partecipazioni in una prova di Coppa del Mondo.
Trap Conca Verde has organized this event this year in substitution of the World Cup that should have been in Egypt.
Avrebbe dovuto essere svolta in Egitto. All'inizio eravamo.
At the beginning, we were worried about this because, of course, there are no quota places, and we weren't able to offer the shooters a high level of competition.
Delle gare di sostanza, delle gare in preparazione, però.
But again, the response of the shooters in the world of shooting was exceptional. And for this, we have 76 countries and 510 shooters.
Con 510 tiratori. Abbiamo ottenuto di organizzare I campionati del.
We are the host country for the 2015 World Championships, and there will be some improvements to be made here.
Dobbiamo migliorare ancora qualcosina per quanto riguarda.
We have to improve a couple small things with the results management, but I'm sure for 2015, everything will be ready to show the world that once again, the Italian organization is perfect, and that Italy is one of the most important countries in the shotgun world.
Il tirovolo in Italia, cioè la nazione dove questo sport è il più seguito.
Good afternoon, shooting fans, and welcome to the Trap Conca Verde shooting range for the first competition of our time here, Trap Women. With only three targets separating first from sixth, and with such talented athletes, this will prove to be a very exciting final. Great Britain's 2007 Junior World Championship silver medalist Abby Burton enters in first place with a total of 70 targets. The standings after shot 22 have Burton and Galvez neck to neck. Shot 23 for Slovakia's 2008 Olympic Games silver medalist Stefakova. Another miss. Japan's one-time World Cup gold medalist Nakayama follows in Stefakova's footsteps. San Marino's two-time World Cup gold medalist Pirelli. The misses are contagious. Spain's Galvez. She breaks a missing streak with a hit. Finland's 2008 Olympic Games gold medalist is in the groove. Burton. This miss is going to change the standings. As I said, the standings have changed. Galvez, who is having an outstanding season this year, has overtaken Burton. Stefakova coming off a miss with a hit. Nakayama is also back in the game. Pirelli, who had a great season last year, nails the clay. Galvez, who just won the gold in London, still holding on to first place. The two-time World Championships bronze medalist. It's hers. Burton, currently holding on to second place, comes back with a hit. One more bird to go, and Galvez is in the lead. Stefakova finishes with a hit and in sixth place. Nakayama, zeroing in, nails the last clay and finishes in fourth. Pirelli, cheek strongly meeting the stalk, finishes in fifth. Galvez needs this bird for her second gold of the season. And it flies away from her. Macanumella is going for the bronze, and she'll be on the podium with that hit. Burton needs this last clay to be in a shoot-off for the gold. The British team and spectators are thrilled. Burton, who's never entered into a World Cup before, starting off with a hit, and does it again. Galvez, the pressure's on, and it gets away from her. Gold medalist Burton getting a very well-deserved hug from her boyfriend after winning her very first World Cup medal, the most brilliant one of all. Burton, Galvez, and Macanumella, winners of Trap Women.
I'm feeling pretty good right now. Obviously, it's my first senior final with making my break from the junior, you know, my junior career at world and European level and competing at World Cup. So, no, I'm very pleased to have made that final and come away with the gold.
Good afternoon and welcome to the gorgeous 12 layout range here at the Trap Conca Verde shooting range. Turkey's 2010 World Cup final gold medalist, Aguzhan Tuzun, enters tied in first place with a total of 121 targets. Our six finalists today, with veteran shooters going against a couple of men who have never entered into a final round of a World Cup before. The standings after shot 22 have Tuzun in first with a two-target advantage after previously having a malfunction with his shotgun. San Marino Selva crushes target 23 with ease. Egypt's Kamar, who's never entered into a final round of a World Cup before, coming off a miss, lets another one go. Italy's 2011 World Cup final silver medalist Vigano is in the zone. The Russian Federation's 2004 Olympic Games gold medalist Alipov. France's Clément needs this bird to stay tied with Vigano. No problems for Clément. On to the leader, Tuzun. Another bird for the two-time World Cup gold medalist. The standings haven't changed. We still have Clément tied up with Vigano for the silver. Two more shots to go. And Selva with a miss on the 24th. Kamar, coming off two misses, nails it squarely. Vigano, a two-time World Cup gold medalist. The Italians are liking this. Alipov, the 2008 Olympic Games bronze medalist, with a hit. Once again, Clément has to get this bird to stay tied with Vigano, and it's his. Tuzun with a two-target advantage. Nails just another one. One more shot to go, and Vigano and Clément are still tied up for second place. Last shot for Selva, who's coming off a miss. With a hit and in fifth place. Kamar finishing his very first round of a World Cup with a hit in sixth place. Vigano, last year's World Cup silver medalist in Sydney, finishes off strong. Alipov, a two-time World Championship silver medalist, finishes off with a hit and in fourth place. Clément has to nail the last bird in order to enter into the shoot-off with Vigano. And he's in. Tuzun has already bagged the gold and finishes off with a hit. Gold medalist Aguzhan Tuzun from Turkey. A great victory for the 29-year-old shooter. As you know, we're headed off for a shoot-off between Vigenault and Clément for the silver. Vigenault with two hits under his belt. Does it again. Once again, the pressure's on Clément. And the shoot-off is finished. Silver medal going to Rodolfo Vigenault from Italy, and the bronze to Stéphane Clément from France.
This
was an important competition for us, the second competition this year. We prepared well during the preparation period. At the end, I'm very happy because I entered into the final with quite a good score, 121 targets. I won a medal for my country. This is my happiness. Good afternoon, friends, and welcome once again to the Trap Concaverde shooting range for the first event of the day, Double Trap Men. USA's 2010 world champion Joshua Richmond enters in third place with a total of 144 targets. It's going to be a tight final with only three targets separating first through sixth, and these incredibly talented men are going to fight hard for the gold. Richmond holding on to first with a two-target advantage. Malta's one-time World Cup gold medalist William Cicutti nails the pair. One-time World Cup bronze medalist Al-Shamasi crushes the birds. Bokiv, who's holding on to second, and shooting with style. Richmond in the zone.
Ball.
Another double. Mosin, the second Russian in today's final, finishing off strong. Kuwait's 2000 Olympic Games bronze medalist, also with a strong finish. We still have Richmond in first, followed by Fokiv and Mosin and Aldehani tied for third. Again on to Cicutti, who won the silver in Tucson this year. He gets another double. Al-Shamasi, who had some difficulty during the final, blows the double out of the air. Fokiv, still holding on to second place by one target, is shooting incredibly today. Our number one shooter, Richmond. He makes it look so easy. Mazen, who's tied up for third, needs this double to stay in the game. And he does it. Aldehani, a two-time World Cup final bronze medalist, having some trouble in the beginning, is finishing off strong. The standings haven't changed. We've got two more doubles to determine the podium. Cicutti, another beautiful pair. Onto Al-Shamasi, the 43-year-old shooter blows the birds into pieces. Fokiv, two more doubles, and if he can nail them, the silver will be his. Richmond, with a newborn baby waiting at home, is unstoppable. Mosin, still tied for third place, gets the pair. The pressure's on Aldehani, and he holds up to it. One more double, and we'll see who's going to be on the podium. Cicutti finishes in good form and in fifth place. Al-Shamasi. An unfortunate way to end the final and in sixth place. Fokiv needs this last double for the silver, and it's his. Richmond needs just one of these clays to land on the highest step of the podium. And the gold is his. Mosin, the pressure's on for the bronze. And he finishes clean. Aldehani, if he gets the last two clays, he'll be in a shoot-off for the bronze. Oh yeah, we're in for a shoot-off, ladies and gentlemen. Gold medalist Joshua Richmond getting congratulated by his coach, Brett Erickson. a smiling silver medalist, Vitaly Fokiv. And 190 targets tying up Aldihani and Mohsen. Coming off a miss on the third double, Mohsen has to zero in and nail the pair. And it's done. The pressure's back on Aldihani. And there you go, the shoot-off's over, and Mohsen gets the bronze. Bronze medalist Vasily Mohsen getting congratulated by silver medalist Falky. Richmond, Falkiv, and Mohsen, medal winners for Double Trap Men.
Okay. Everything's kind of lining up perfectly here before the Olympics, but I'm certain I don't want to put the cart in front of the horse here by any means. I just want to keep working hard and keep climbing that ladder, and hopefully I'm a main contender in London.
Good afternoon, and once again, welcome to the beautiful Trap Conca Verde shooting range for the second final of the day, Skeet Woman. Slovakia's three-time World Championships bronze medalist Danka Bartakova enters in first place with a two-target advantage over the others. With only three targets separating first from sixth place, it will prove to be an exciting final. The standings after Station 7 have Bartakova with only one target advantage, Wenzel in second and a tie for third. Station 8 for 2004 Olympic Games silver medalist Wei Ning, who just over a week ago won the gold in London, finishes in fifth place. USA's two-time World Cup silver medalist, Caitlin Connor, finishes off strong, but in sixth place. USA's 2008 Olympic Games silver medalist, Kimberly Rode, who had an accident recently, badly bruising her ribs and elbow, finishes off clean. Germany's 2008 Olympic Games bronze medalist, Christine Wenzel. If she can get this last target, the silver will be hers. Silver medalist, Christine Wenzel. Chile's 22-year-old Francisca Croveto Shadid. If she can clear this station, she'll be going up against Rode for the bronze. And the pressure's on with one more to go. Provetto Shadid is going for the bronze. Last two for the two-time World Cup silver medalist, Danka Bartakova, who had an unfortunate time on Station 6. She just needs these two for the gold. One down and one to go. And there it is. Gold medalist, Danka Bartakova. As you can see, Croveto Shadid and Rode have finished with 93 targets and a shoot-off for the bronze. Rode shooting first. A miss from Rode. Can young Croveto Shadid hold up to the pressure? Oh, yes, she can. Bronze medalist Francisca Croveto Shadid, radiating joy with her winner's smile. Bartakova, Wenzel, and Croveto Shadid, medal winners. We'll see how it continues, but I feel really great because I've made some changes last year in December, so I'm really happy they paid off. Good afternoon, shooting fans, and welcome to the last final here at the Trap Conca Verde shooting range, Skeet Men. Cyprus's 2007 world champion George Archelaos enters into the final in a three-way tie for first with 122 targets. Once again, it's going to be a tight competition with only two targets separating first from sixth. The standings after Station 7 have Archelaus and Showman tied for first and Jensen in third. Station 8 for Greece's one-time World Cup gold medalist Mitas. A hit on the high house. And again on the low house. Norway's 2008 Olympic Games silver medalist Tori Brovald, who experienced only one miss, the low house target on the first pair of the fourth station. Finishes by nailing both birds. Italy's one-time World Cup bronze medalist Luigi Lode, who also missed a bird during the final, the low house single on the fifth station, gets the high house and onto the low house. Another hit. The Russian Federation's 2010 world champion, Valery Showman, needs these two birds for a perfect final and also a chance for the gold. On to the low house. He's in the running for the gold. Cyprus's 2007 World Cup final gold medalist George Archelaus shooting a perfect final. If he can clear the eighth station, he'll be in a shoot-off for the gold. He's crushed the high house onto the low house. It's on the line for the two-time World Cup final bronze medalist. There's going to be a shoot-off for the gold. Denmark's one-time World Cup bronze medalist, Jesper Hansen. He needs these two for the bronze. He's got the high house, and now the low house. The bronze is his. Archelaus and Showman neck to neck in a shoot-off for the gold. Showman, 12 targets nailed. Let's see how the next two go. Oh, one's got away from him. The pressure's on Archelaus. The door is open and waiting for him to enter into the land of gold. Can he break the curse of missed birds and shoot-offs that has been haunting him for the last year? Two puffs of pink powder says it all. Ladies and gentlemen, Archelaus is back. Gold medalist George Archelaus has done it, and everyone is thrilled. Archelaus, Showman and Hansen, medalists for Skeet Man. I'm very satisfied with my result. I was really confident before the competition. I shot in London pre-Olympics. I was seventh. So I think it was about time to get on the podium. And of course, the gold medal makes me very happy. So that's a wrap for the last stage of the 2012 ISSF World Cup in Shotgun here at the Trap Conca Verde Shooting Range. And onto the road of the 2012 London Games. Good luck to all of you fine athletes.